of large data breaches, but most cases of ID theft are not conducted by nameless, faceless hackers. They're pulled off by people with access to our personal information. A woman who became a victim managed to turn the tables on the people who targeted her.
Why are you sending me a credit card with a limit of $35,000 when I haven't applied for it?
That was Ibe May's question to the bank after she received a new credit card in the mail.
I said, something is going on.
Her suspicions were soon validated.
I'm pulling into my house, and sure enough, I see an SUV parked in front of my house and somebody from the passenger side leaning into my mailbox.
She called police but had few details. That changed 2 days later when she saw the car again.
I let them go past me and I turn around, and this time I got behind them and I got the license plate.
Turns out Carlos and Catherine Molina had been using May's identity for months. They took out multiple credit cards and even submitted a change of address for her mail.
It's a very eerie feeling. It's like having an evil twin you never knew you had.
May now has a credit alert on all of her accounts. If anyone tries to start a new account with her information, she is alerted.
You have to become your own advocate. You have to go to the credit card companies. You have to go to the banks. You have to tell them, this is not me.
Postal inspectors say all consumers should get a credit report at least once a year.
If you do confirm that it's identity theft, contact your local police department first. Once you contact your local police department, make sure that the credit reporting bureau knows that it was identity theft, and contact your postal inspectors in order to file a complaint so that an investigation can be initiated and the documentation process begins.
Identity theft, it's an assault that keeps happening, and it happens to you continuously, and it could go away for a few years and then come back.
Carlos and Catherine Molina pleaded guilty to ID theft and aggravated ID theft. A judge also ordered them to pay more than $18,000 in restitution.